Now I'll show you the working of GRN transaction from the purchase module. So go to purchase, transaction and GRN. So click on the add button. So now this is the GRN form. So you can see this is the GRN voucher type. You can make a new voucher type if you want as per your requirement. From here you can select the supplier using F5. And if you directly know the supplier account number, you could just write the number over here and you can see the supplier has been selected. And you can select the GRN number. You can configure the GRN number from voucher type. Based on your requirement, you can set the prefix or the suffix. Fill in the additional details, delivery note number, select the GRN date. And if you want to make the GRN in foreign based transaction, you can select the currency from here and set the exchange rate. You can write the reference number over here. And now going to the other step, you can write the narration, the address, customs entry number and brief description of VAT. You can make the GRN either independently by writing the item name over here, or if you want to use it, use the reference of purchase order. You can select the PO from here. As you can see, the item has been loaded over here. And now you can proceed to save the transaction. Now regarding the fields in the grid, I'll explain to you. As you can see, this is the part number, the item name, description, warehouse, the last purchase price, the unit, unit ratio, tax, whether it's VATable or exempt, and the tax type, whether inclusive or exclusive, the quantity. Now this is the number of pieces column, the rate, discount and amount. And here you can see it's the remarks and the extra note that you want to write in, and here's the PO number that has been linked. And below you can, here's the other charge that I had already set up. Now you can write the other charges over here. The additional charges is 10 shillings and okay, so as you can see other charges being there. And below you can see here's the total quantity, the subtotal, tax amount, discount, discount amount and rounding, that is again configured from voucher type. So this is actually the total amount that is payable. And now you can save this GRN. Now here's actually the grid. From here only, it's from here itself you can edit the transaction. And from here you can print the transaction, attach the documents, or you could cancel the transaction. So this is the medium through it. And if you want to see all the purchase related transactions, you could go to purchase, transaction and daybook. And here you can view all the transactions of purchase module, that is quotation, invoice, goods receipt, requisitions, everything is here in one particular medium. Now going to next, we'll go to purchase invoice. So the same, this is the form of purchase invoice. As usual, this is the purchase invoice type. Here's the supplier, as it's common everywhere. You can using F5 or you could directly write the account number. And the invoice number, you can configure it from voucher type. And here you could fill in the additional details, supplier invoice number. And here's the invoice date, supplier invoice date and the invoice date. And same as mentioned earlier, you can, if you want to make it in foreign currency, you can select the foreign currency from here. And in the others tab, you can fill in the narration, address, cost center, profile. Okay. And if you want to make the invoice independently, that also you can make it. Just write the part number over here. And or you could, if you want to raise it against the GRN, which I am doing right now. So as you can see, the invoice has been raised against the GRN. The same way, here also the grid is same as GRN, that is the part number, item name, description, warehouse, unit, tax, inclusive or exclusive, the quantity, number of pieces, the rate, discount, line level if you want to give, and again remarks and extra note. And same, the below is also the same, other charges, total quantity, subtotal tax amount and header level discount. If you want to give it over here, you can see there is the discount. And now you can proceed to save the transaction. Okay, now this is the allocation form. So here is the reference type. Whatever reference that you want to select, against reference, new reference and on account. I'll be selecting new reference over here. So you can see a number has been, new bill number has been generated. Here's the bill date and here's the amount. And I'll click on OK. So the transaction has been saved. Now same way, you could edit it from here. You could resave the transaction. You can print it, you can cancel it, you can attach the documents. And if you want to view the accounting entry, the shortcut is Ctrl+Alt+Shift+V. So as you can see, there is another tab, voucher ledger details. So in, from here you can view actually the account entry that has been, the voucher that has been posted on the view back. So this is actually the purpose of this. Now going to next is purchase return. Now if you want to raise a return against a particular GRN, if there is a product, so the same way, this is the purchase return form. You can select the purchase return type from here, that is the voucher type. The return code can be configured from purchase return voucher type, selecting the purchase return date. And the same way, F5 for using customer, or directly write it, the account number and the currency. And in the others tab, you can fill in the narration and the address. So now if you want to raise it against a particular GRN, here's the GRN, okay. And as you can see, the item has been loaded over here. And now I will return one quantity from the GRN that I had raised. So you can see below, the total amount is 43,103. So this is how a return can be generated against a particular GRN. Now I'll proceed to save this. So in the same way, you can open the transaction, you can resave it, you could print it, you could cancel it, attach the documents from here. Now purchase return actually doesn't make an entry, it gives a stock effect entry. I mean, it doesn't give the accounting entry. So this will actually reduce your stock. This particular item stock will be reduced by 1. So in order to give the effect in the accounts, you need to raise purchase return invoice. So from here, so this is the form of purchase return invoice. Same type, same thing. Select the, here's the voucher type. Select the supplier. Okay. And here's the invoice number, configure it from voucher type, and here's again the invoice date and the currency. And in the others detail tab, write in the narration, address, cost center profile, customs entry number, brief description of VAT. And from here you could select the particular return that you had generated and now you want it to raise the effect in the accounts. So same way, as you can see, the quantity 1 that previously which I had generated. And now I will be saving this transaction, and here you can select the reference type. Okay, so this is in the same way, you can edit it and use the shortcut Ctrl+Alt+Shift+V, and here is this particular effect. So this is how you can actually, this is the basic working of the transactions in purchase module. And if you go in reports, you can see there are many sorts of reports over here as per your requirement: requisition summary, requisition criteria wise details, GRN details report, repurchase register report, close PO report. So these are the reports that are available for the client to use.